Okay, we're going to look here at how we do long multiplication, and today we're going to look at two methods. One is what I'm going to call the traditional algorithm, and the second method is what people generally call the grid method. And for both these examples, I'm going to do the sum 29 times 35. Right, so this is going to be an example of the traditional algorithm for doing long multiplication. So the sum we're going to do is 29 times 35, and I've laid that out in a grid with thousands, hundreds, tens and units. And what I'm going to do is take it stage by stage. So the first thing I'm going to do is 5 times 9, which is 45. So I'm going to put the 5 there, and I'm going to put the 4 there because I'm carrying it. Then I'm going to do 5 times 2, which is 10, but I've got to add the 4 there, which I carried. So 5 2s are 10, add 4 is 14, so 4 there and 1 there. What I go on and do now is I'm now going to be working with the 3. Now the 3's in the tens column, so the very first thing I'm going to do is add a 0 there. And then it's very similar to before. I'm going to do 3 9s, which are 27. So the 7 goes there, and I'll carry the 2. Then I'm going to do 3 2s, which are 6. Add the 2 that I've carried, which makes 8. And my final step now is to add up the previous 2 lines. So that one and that one. And so I put the add sign there. So I do it in the kind of traditional way. I do 5 add 0 is 5. I do 4 add 7, which is 11. So 1 goes there and carry the 1. Then I do 8 add 1, which is 9. Add the 1 which I carry is 10. So I get a final answer of 1015. And if I just circle that, so that's my final answer for the sum 29 times 35 is 1015, which is 1015. The second method is what's called the grid method, and again I'm going to do 29 times 35. It's pretty worth noting to start with that 29 I've broken down to 20 and 9. And then in a similar way, I've broken the 35 down into 30 and 5. Now, all I do now is literally kind of work round square by square. So first sum is I do 30 times 20, which is 600. And then the second sum that I do is I do 30 times 9, which is 270. The third sum that I do, just working round, is I do 5 times 20, which is 100. And the final sum is I do 5 times 9, which is 45. And then I just need to add them all together to get a final answer. So I just do a traditional sum. So if I line them up, 600, 270, 145, if I put my plus sign on, and then I just add down the columns. So if I just do them one by one, so if I do the units, 0, 0, 0, and 5 is 5. If I then look at the second column, 0, 7, 0, and 4 is 11, so 1 there. Carry the 1, and then if I look at the hundreds column, it's 6, 2, 1, and 1. So 6, 2, 1, and 1 is 10. So that goes there like that. So my final answer to 29 times 35 is 1015, which is 1015, which we can be reassured is the same as the answer that we got for the other method, which is really good. Finally, I hope you find this short video on long multiplication useful. Any problems, any queries, don't hesitate to get in touch. Thank you very much.